Ambassador Cui, China has been talking about the Global Development Initiative, GDI, and today at the Boao Forum for Asia opening ceremony, Chinese President proposed a Global Security Initiative.
I think this stands for the goals of China's foreign policy, global peace and global development. I think these are the real challenges facing the international community. The problem is not how to define these terms. I think the problem for some of the countries, some of the so-called major countries, is whether they have the political will to commit themselves to these goals.
Who are you referring to, Mr. Ambassador?
I think we all know who I'm referring to. These major powers, they have great power, of course, they have big influence globally, but sometimes these influences are not used, their power is not applied in a very constructive way.
Mr. Ambassador, some already suggesting that we are in the middle of a new Cold War or Cold War 2.0. I know you disagree with those terminologies. I asked you that question before, but what do you make of the reality? Where are we now?
I think we are at a very important crossroads in global history. Where should we go? Are we going to build together a community of nations for a shared future, a bright future for everybody, or are we going back to the darkness? I hope they remember, during the old Cold War years, we had two major hot wars in Asia, which caused a lot of suffering to the Asia-Pacific region. I think we, people in Asia and the Pacific region, we certainly reject any attempt to reinitiate such Cold War or even hot war.
Mr. Ambassador, your former counterpart, the former U.S. Ambassador to China, Max Baucus, recently in an interview, he said it's not necessarily we're entering into a Cold War of a nuclear Cold War, but rather Cold War of culture and technologies. He's warning against the danger of moving into it. Do you agree with him?
I fully share the concerns of my good friend Max. I think he has pointed out this danger, this risk for the world, and this is quite real. I don't know why some people are so obsessed with block confrontation with so-called new Cold War. It may not be a nuclear war, it could be a war of culture, technology. But I think the consequences would be the same or even worse, because they are trying to divide the global community into different blocks to serve their own narrow interests, while the real need is for all of us to unite, to come together.